क्वेश्चन नंबर 176। ड्यूरिंग द पेंडेंसी ऑफ एन अपील बाय द फोर डिफेंडेंट्स इन द सूट वन ऑफ द अपीलेंट डिफेंडेंट डाइस एंड नो स्टेप्स फॉर सब्स्टिट्यूशन फॉर हिज लीगल रिप्रेजेंटेटिव आर टेकन एंड द अपील इन सो फार एज इट रिलेट्स टू द सेड अपीलेंट अबेट्स द फाइव रिस्पोंडेंट्स प्लेंटिफ अप्लाई फॉर डिसमिसल ऑफ द एंटायर अपील एज अबेटेड आंसर वेदर द एंटायर अपील अबेट्स एंड हैज टू बी डिसमिस्ड द एंटायर अपील अबेट्स ओनली इफ द कॉज ऑफ एक्शन अगेंस्ट ऑल ऑफ द डिफेंडेंट्स वॉज वन एंड अलाउंग द अपील ऑफ द Other defendants would lead to inconsistent decrees. The appeal should only be of the deceased appellant abates and as far as the other defendant appellants are concerned has to continue. The proceedings in the appeal have to be stayed and the second appeal is required to be filed for the determination of this question. Correct answer is option second. That is, the entire appeal abates only if the cause of action against all the defendants was won and allowing the appeal of the other defendants would lead to inconsistent decrees. Question number 177. The court at the first hearing of the suit can only frame issues, may permit cross-examination of the either party of the other to elucidate the matters and the controversy in the suit, may examine either of the parties, and option 4, none of these. Correct answer is option 3, that is to elucidate the matters in controversy in the suit, may examine either of the parties. Question number 178. Failure of the judgment debtor to file affidavit of assets under Order 21 Rule 41 Clause 2 of the Code of Civil Procedure can result in civil imprisonment up to 3 months for the judgment debtor, civil imprisonment up to 6 months for the judgment debtor, civil imprisonment up to 9 months for the judgment debtor. Option 4, imposition of fine on the judgment debtor of the deceitful amount. Correct answer is option 1st, that is civil imprisonment up to 3 months for the judgment debtor. Question number 179. Parties A and B have agreed on the seat of arbitration. The same can be changed by the arbitral tribunal unilaterally, cannot be changed at all, can be changed by the agreement of parties, cannot be changed by the parties unless arbitral tribunal permits. Correct answer is option 3rd, that is can be changed by the agreement of parties. Question number 180. An application to set aside the arbitral award under the Arbitration and Conciliation Act 1996 may be made within a time period of the following number of days that have elapsed from the date on which the party making the application had received the arbitral award. Options are 1 month, 2 months, 3 months and 45 days. Correct answer is option 3rd, that is 3 months. Question number 181. An arbitration agreement entered on 1st August 2019 provides for the arbitration to be in accordance with the Arbitration Act 1940. The arbitration would be governed by the provisions of the Arbitration Conciliation Act 1996. The arbitration would be governed by the provisions of Arbitration Act 1940. The arbitration clause is void. And option 4, the arbitration award would be governed by the provisions of the Arbitration Act 1940 as well as the Arbitration Conciliation Act 1996. Here the correct answer is option 1st, that is the arbitration would be governed by the provisions of the Arbitration Conciliation Act 1996. Question number 182. The arbitration agreement expressly asks the jurisdiction of the consumer forums in such a case. Only arbitral tribunal will have the jurisdiction. Only consumer forum will have the jurisdiction as it's a special act. Both for a will have jurisdiction to adjudicate the disputes. The clause would be void, only a civil suit would lie. Correct answer is option 3rd, that is both will have jurisdiction to adjudicate the disputes. Question number 183. An arbitration clause contained in a deficiently stamped and compulsorily registrable document is enforceable even without deficient stamp duty being paid, is enforceable only if the deficient stamp duty along with the penalty, if any, is paid, is invalid, is enforceable only if the deficient stamp duty along with the penalty, if any, is paid and the document is registered. Here the correct answer is option 2nd, that is enforceable only if the deficient stamp duty along with the penalty, if any, is paid. Question number 184. A non-signatory to the arbitration agreement can be made party to the arbitration proceedings under some circumstances or grounds. Question number 185. In a pending arbitration case, the arbitral tribunal passed an order of interim injunction under section 17 of the Arbitration Conciliation Act 1996 restraining in an encashment of a bank guarantee. The aggrieved party has the following remedies: file a review before the arbitrator, file an appeal under section 37 of the Arbitration Conciliation Act 1996, file a civil suit challenging the interim order, and option 4, none of these. Correct answer is option 2nd, that is file an appeal under section 37 of the Arbitration Conciliation Act. Section 37 talks about the appealable order. Question number 186. Disputes between A and B are referred to the arbitration under the Arbitration Conciliation Act 1996. The final award is rendered 1st June 2019 in favor of B. During the ensuing summer vacations of the court, an urgent situation arises in which B wishes to seek interim relief, B can approach the arbitral tribunal under the Section 17 of the Arbitration Conciliation Act 1996 for interim orders. Option 2, approach the court of competent jurisdiction under Section 9 of the Arbitration Conciliation Act 1996 for interim orders. Not obtain any interim orders as the final award has been passed. Approach the Supreme Court for interim order. Correct answer is option 2. That is, approach the court of competent jurisdiction under Section 9 of the Arbitration Conciliation Act 1996 for interim orders. Question number 187. Under Section 8 of the Arbitration Conciliation Act 1996, the reference parties to the arbitration is mandatory. Correct answer is mandatory. Question number 188. A nomination of an arbitrator is made by a person who is himself ineligible act as an arbitrator under Section 12, Clause 5, read with 7 schedule to the Arbitration Conciliation Act 1996. In such a case, the nominee cannot act as an arbitrator. Such a nomination would be void ab initio, both first and second. Such nomination is valid. Correct answer is option 3, that is both first and second. The nominee cannot act as an arbitrator. Such a nomination would be void ab initio. Question number 189. A petition for execution of an arbitral award for the recovery of money by attachment and sale of immovable property of the judgment debtor at Delhi is filed at New Delhi. Though the objections against the arbitral award were dismissed by the court at Ludhiana and without seeking transfer from the court, would the execution petition is maintainable? Correct answer is yes, it is maintainable. Question number 190. The parties to the arbitration agreement are resident of Lucknow and Kolkata. The contract was performed at Varanasi. The parties agreed that arbitration proceedings will be conducted at New Delhi and were held at New Delhi. Where will the petition under Section 34 of the Arbitration Conciliation Act 1996 be filed? Options are Delhi, Lucknow, Varanasi, Kolkata. Correct answer is Delhi. An application under Section 8 of the Arbitration Conciliation Act 1996 is filed by the defendant after the defendant has filed his written statement on merits and after framing of issues in which no issue qua arbitrarily is framed. The court must issue notice of the application to plaintiff and call for reply. Allow the application if there is an arbitration agreement. Dismiss the same as not maintainable. Frame an issue on the same to be determined at trial. Correct answer is option 3. That is, dismiss the same as not maintainable. Question number 192. A petition under Section 34 of the Arbitration Conciliation Act 1996 is filed on the 41st day after the expiry of limitation prescribed Section 34 Clause 3 of the said Act, along with an application for condonation of delay is filing thereof. The petitioner makes out sufficient ground for the condoning delay. The court must condone delay and issue notice of petition under Section 34 of the Arbitration Conciliation Act 1996 to respondent. Issue notice to respondent only by the application seeking condonation of delay. Dismiss the application for the condonation of delay as well as a petition under Section 34 of the Arbitration Conciliation Act 1996 on the ground of limitation. Issue notice of the application seeking condonation of delay as well as of the petition under Section 34 of the Arbitration Conciliation Act. Correct answer is option 3. That is, dismiss the application for condonation of delay as well as the petition under Section 34 of the Arbitration Conciliation Act 1996 on the ground of limitation. Question number 193. A petition under Section 48 of the Arbitration Conciliation Act 1996 against a foreign award must be filed before District Court having territorial and pecuniary jurisdiction, High Court, Supreme Court, all these. Correct answer is High Court. Question number 194. The petitioner in a petition under Section 34 of the Arbitration Conciliation Act 1996 shows that another method of calculating damages was preferable than one adopted by the arbitrator. The court must set aside the award, demand the award to the arbitrator of reconsideration, dismiss the petition, award damages on the basis of the other method. Correct answer is option 3, that is, dismiss the petition. Question number 195. A institutes a suit against B with respect to the disputes arising out of an agreement entered into with B. The said agreements provide for arbitration of all disputes, including the disputes subject matter of suit. The court before which the suit comes up for admission will dismiss the suit, will refer the disputes and parties of arbitration, will admit the suit if otherwise maintainable in law, will direct the plaintiff to approach the High Court under Section 11 of the Arbitration Conciliation Act 1996 for the appointment of arbitrator. Correct answer is option 3, that is, will admit the suit if otherwise maintainable in law. Question number 196. A has let out of his property at Delhi to B at rent of Rs. 3000 per month on the terms and conditions contained in a registered lease deed. The lease deed provides for arbitration of all disputes between the parties. B fails to vacate the property in spite of expiry of period of lease for 2 years. A initiates arbitral proceedings under the Arbitration Conciliation Act 1996 in accordance with an arbitration clause in the lease deed seeking eviction ejectment of B from the property. Options are: the arbitral proceedings are maintainable, the arbitral proceedings are not maintainable, the arbitral proceedings are maintainable only if B does not object the same, the arbitral proceedings are maintainable with the express consent of B. Correct answer is option second, that is arbitral proceedings are not maintainable. Question number 197. A files a suit against B for recovery of money due under the agreement, term whereof has since expired by efflux of time. B files an application under section 8 of the Arbitration Conciliation Act contending that the agreement contains an arbitration clause. The court would then dismiss the application and continue with the suit as the agreement including the arbitration clause thereof has expired by efflux of time. Option second, refer the parties to the arbitration, and option third, refer the parties to arbitration only if the plaintiff agrees to such arbitration. Option four, refer the parties to the High Court under section 11 of the Arbitration Conciliation Act 1996 for determination if the arbitrator needs to be appointed. Correct answer is option second, that is the refer the parties to the arbitration. Question number 198. The bar under section 42 of the Arbitration Conciliation Act 1996 is not applicable to application under section 8 of the said act, application under section 11 of the said act, application under act filed in a court that has no jurisdiction subject matter, and option 4, all of these. Correct answer is option 4, that is all of these. Question number 199. On the very filing of a petition under section 34 of the Arbitration Conciliation Act 1996 for setting aside of an arbitral award in an arbitral proceedings which has commenced after 23-10-2015, the arbitral award becomes an inexecutable, the award is eclipsed. Option 3, the arbitral award remains executable unless execution thereof is stayed by the court before which such petition is filed. Option 4, arbitral award is executable only with the permission of the court before which the petition under section 34 of the Arbitration Conciliation Act 1996 is filed. Correct answer is option 3, that is arbitral award remains executable unless execution thereof is stayed by the court before which such statement is filed. Question number 200. An arbitration agreement provides for the arbitration under the Arbitration Conciliation Act 1996 by two arbitrators, one to be appointed by each party. Options are: the arbitration agreement is void, the arbitration agreement is of arbitration by three arbitrators with the third arbitrator to be appointed by the court, the arbitration agreement is of the arbitrator by one arbitrator either to be appointed jointly by the two parties, and if not the same. Option 4, the arbitration agreement will be enforced as it is. Correct answer is option 3rd, that is the arbitration agreement is of the arbitration by one arbitrator either to be appointed jointly by the two parties, and if not by the court.